So Paul, why is persistence important, and how many prototypes can you expect to make if you're actually building out an app from scratch?
A lot. Way more than you think you should, or than you think is at all reasonable. Your trash can should be full by the end of the week, every single week. Mm-hmm. And I'm not talking about full-blown interactive JavaScript prototypes. That's going to take a lot longer. I'm talking about sketched prototypes. Mm-hmm. When you start, you want to focus on iterating quickly in the cheapest possible medium, and often that can be crayons, right? Mm-hmm. You go out to every time I go out to a restaurant, mm-hmm. I ask for a kid's menu and crayons if I see them. So that if I have an idea or I want to jot something down or whatever, mm-hmm. I have pen and paper there and I can sketch it out.
Right.
There are a couple different iPhone apps if you're doing mobile development that let you turn sketches very quickly into kind of mock interactive prototypes.
Right.
But it works perfectly fine just to sit there and actually move the paper around to create the impression of interactivity.
Right.
And interactive prototypes are great because you can make them super, super, super fast, and you can make them super quickly, right?
Right.
Sketching out 10 prototypes, 10 full flows through your app should take you no more than an hour or two. Mm-hmm. And then you take those prototypes around to 5 different people in your office and walk them through each one, and now you have an amazing amount of user testing data that's going to be invaluable as you start to move into interactive prototypes or like click-through prototypes or full JavaScript interactive prototypes.
And as time goes on, you'll get faster at building these prototypes and at finding users to test with.
Exactly, yeah. As you go on, you'll get better at knowing which interactions or how to represent interactions in paper. Mm-hmm. You'll get better with your tools, your interactive click-through tools. You'll get, if you start coding, better at JavaScript. So you'll get more better at talking to the developers who are actually building the prototype about which things matter to speed that up. Mm-hmm. And as you get better at that, of course, you get faster. And so you can really tear through prototypes and just throw them out at the end. So one thing that's really important to remember about these paper prototypes and interactive prototypes is that the first times that you make them, you're going to look at them and you're going to say, this sucks. This is terrible. Mm-hmm. This is not the right solution. And that's fine. That's absolutely perfect.
Right.
Your goal is not to find the right solution the first time. Your goal is to iterate lots and 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 lots of times, and eventually find the best solution.
Right.
Separate from that, as a designer, as a prototyper yourself, you're going to look at this and say, "This is not the best thing that I could have made." Right. Mm-hmm. Your craft will not be very good. That's fine. You're going to suck at this for a long time before you're good at it.
Right.
That's part of doing this. And because you're doing so many of these, you're going to get better really fast. And so the best thing that you can do is just keep going. Just keep making prototypes, keep sketching, keep making interactive prototypes. Mm-hmm. You will get faster, you will get better, it will get easier. Just keep going.